Hi, my name is Tom and you are at level 29 in Mastering Einstein's Special Relativity. This episode talks about proper time. Let's get into it. Let me move my mouse to the window and there it is. Here we see three observers, number one, number two, number three. Number one is not so kind. Number two is a little bit kind, and number three is a really kind person. You can tell by their colors. And number one says, I'm not moving, you all are moving, but not me. And that's true, you know, in special relativity, all observers consider themselves to be at rest, and all the other observers moving around them, and they are all right from their individual perspective. But number two says, no. And number three says, okay, let's agree to disagree. Yeah. And then they have another conversation. Number one says, if I see 4 seconds passing by on my clock, then that's 4 seconds. I don't care if other people tell me it was more or less than 4 seconds. 4 seconds it is. I don't care about the others. The person in blue says, well, in that case, I think I have to treat you the same way. So in my world, my clock rules. And number three says, let's respect each other's clocks. That's just the proper thing to do. And that's almost like defining proper time. Einstein does an intervention. He says, listen, if you do the math, you will all agree about the time passing on someone else's clock from their perspective. That's the catch. And I call it proper time. Number one says, whatever. Number two is curious. And number three is already a big fan of this guy called Einstein. So let's see if I can define it a few more times. So we learned in previous levels that clocks get out of sync once they start moving at different speeds. We learned that we disagree about locations, about length, about distances. We don't even agree on when things happen at the same time. So is there nothing real in this universe? Well, there is. There are some things that are real in this universe. And one of them is the speed of light. No matter which observer you are, no matter how fast the others are moving relative to you, do you all agree on the speed of light? It's like a law of physics. It doesn't change when you switch perspective. And the same is true for proper time. Suppose we have three observers, observer 1, 2, and 3. And number 2 and 3 are watching number 1. And number 1 experiences two events at his location, 0, and he measures the time difference between those two events. So observer 1, 2 events, calculates the time difference, both location 0. Observer 2 and 3 also witnessed those two events. They will write down when they saw these events, at which locations they saw these locations, and then they all will disagree about locations and times. This is just the way special relativity is. But there's one thing they all agree on. When they all calculate the time difference between those two events. Now the catch, from the perspective of observer one, then they all agree. And that's why it's called proper time. Observer two will say, I measured the time difference of 20 seconds, but I know your clock, number one, will have measured 10. And observer 3 will say the same. He will say, I measured maybe 30 seconds between the two events, but I can do the math, and your clock, observer 1, will have told you it's a time difference of 10 seconds. They agree on this delta T, proper time. It's a bit confusing because it's delta time. But if the first time is at zero, then delta time is the same as time. You know, but try to think of this as delta time. I think that's better than just time. Another way of defining it, you usually use the Greek T, which is tau. It's proprietary to the observer sitting on the moving clock. Well, the clock is not moving. It's his clock, his stationary clock, which is moving for all the other observers. And that's where he measures the events. It's also the shortest delta T. So if you are where the action is, the delta T between the two actions is the smallest. Other observers moving at different speeds will measure longer delta T's for these two events. This is it. Clocks, time dilation, proper time. Well, not time dilation, proper time, I would say. Time dilation is why the other observers disagree about delta time from their perspective, but they all agree from the delta, from the delta T from the perspective of the observer, which is at the focus point, in this case, number one. So this is it. Thank you for watching. If you want to know more about special relativity, I've made like 18 levels here. You can pause the video. And then another batch all the way up to the twin paradox in level number 34. We are now at level number... I forgot which level we are. 29A, proper time. If you want to only follow the headlines, you can follow the green. So you could even skip the space-time interval. But, you know, of course you want to know more. And I promise you, proper time is much more intuitive in the B level, where we use the space-time diagram, which was introduced in level 26. If you use the space-time diagram, you can just point your finger at the proper time instead of using the words. I find that more intuitive, but it's up to you. I hope to see you there. Thank you for watching.